I need to come clean, Anderson. I know why Nightingale was here 13 years ago. He was chasing a writer, Alan Wake.
Tammy mentioned him. She's writing a book on his disappearance.
You know the detective character from his books, Alex Casey.
Yeah, I've heard the jokes at the office. Cold case Casey. Murder case Casey. Sorry.
Ha ha. The same name, similar job. It's the first thing anyone thinks of. It annoyed me, but that was it. Then, 10 years ago, I started getting strange letters in the mail. Fragments of prose describing murders. You've heard the stories about what happened in New York. Some of it, at least. Bodies started to pile up. It was a murder cult. Turns out the fragments sent to me were from the crime books of Alan Wake. The cult was copycatting the murders from the books. In their heads, they were performing a ritual to bring Wake back. Their imagined prophet. After that case, I started looking into Wake's disappearance on the side.
And you thought this case might be connected to him? His name does keep popping up.
I just wanted you to have all the facts.
Next time, give them to me before we find ourselves in the middle of a horror story. The page says Nightingale's in something called an overlap. Need to figure out exactly what that means.
I'm happy I'm not in charge of this mess.
Thanks. Let's start looking for Nightingale where he was killed. Great. This area is supposed to be close to the public. I have things to do. And this is not the right way. The writer of these pages knows what will happen. Because they're behind this, or because they can see what's coming. Impossible things are happening here. A world operating on different rules. I need to understand this strange logic. To see the clues. To solve the case. I've been thinking more about the cult of the tree. What sort of cult refers to themselves as a cult?
In my experience, they don't.
We're not seeing the full picture yet.
Hey, hello there. How are you folks doing?
Those restricted area signs don't do a damn thing, huh?
Hello. Saga Anderson. Are you two supposed to be here?
I'm Ilmo Koskela. Fantastic to meet you. And yes, Stephen here hired me to show him through the woods. He's in town on important government business. Fixing this impressive piece of hardware.
I work for the FBC, ma'am. I'm authorized to be here.
And I bet you two are here about that murder. Nasty stuff. How's it going?
What is this thing?
It's just a monitoring station, ma'am. The Federal Bureau of Control checks volcanic activity and air toxicity levels. No need to worry, though. It's mostly for research purposes.
That's one gorgeous weather saga. Looks Nordic. I bet a family member made it.
Stephen, we're investigating a murder that occurred nearby. What can you tell me about your bureau?
Nothing that isn't classified, I'm afraid. But I don't know anything about a murder. The operations here are run by a different department. I'm just here to make some repairs. The wiring on this thing frays every couple months.
Yep, that's the raccoons. They grow real big here with teeth like you wouldn't believe. Can gnaw right through a garbage can.
My mother made this sweater for me. How do you know?
I knew it. My mom used to knit those sweaters for me and my brother. Watery, my hometown, was founded by Finnish immigrants. So between your name and the sweater, I figured your family might be from Finland too. Suomi, Finland. Pulla, Karjalan piirakka.
Close. My mom's family is from Sweden originally. I don't know much about them beyond that. The sweater is just something to remember her by. How did you hear about the murder, Ilmo? Do you know anything that could help us?
People tend to tell me things. The Koskela brothers are kind of a household name around here. Speaking of, if you're looking for some fun, stop by Watery. Just down the road from Bright Falls, there's our Coffee World amusement park. There's sauna ja vihta. And we offer a variety of guided tours, hunting, fishing, hiking, whatever strikes your fancy. You name it, we probably got it.
That's all I've got for the moment.
What the hell is this?
What'd you find there, Stephen?
Nothing. Just something that shouldn't be here. Raccoons my ass.
Let's get to the murder site, Casey. A lot of things about this case keep bothering me. But one thing feels really off. Breaker's disappearance. I don't get the feeling Nightingale was responsible.
He was about to give you more of those pages. Something didn't want us to have them? Or was protecting him from Nightingale? Spontaneous combustion? I don't know. Not the kind of disappearance we normally solve. Our crime scene's drowning. I never minded rain. Feels like home.
No sign of Nightingale. But the page did place him at Cauldron Lake, in an overlap. So how do we follow him there?
Maybe something around here will tell us.
We've seen this symbol before.
Good eye.
Monsters, overlaps, rituals. What do you make of all of this?
The killers are usually the ones performing the ritual, not the detective. Acting out their sick fantasy. They may be trying to get you involved, forcing you into their twisted world.
But with dead men coming alive, the word ritual starts to have more weight behind it. We need to look around. Learn what this ritual is. After we find Nightingale, what then? I've never arrested a monster.
I've watched you arrest plenty of monsters, Anderson.
You know what I mean. Monsters. Light worked against him at the morgue. That might be the only way to stop him from hurting anyone else. Bare feet. Nightingale. I'll see where these footprints lead. Can you comb through the crime scene one more time, KC? Just in case?
On it. If anything comes up, I'll radio you.
The tracks lead into the water. Where'd you go from here? I can feel something. A presence. Nightingale isn't far. I know Nightingale is somewhere around Cauldron Lake.
The tree was a threshold. This place and the dark place. You're in over your head. Next stop, Caldera Street Station.
The threshold, like a doorway, leading to Nightingale. It's somehow connected to a tree. Witch's ladle?
The tree was a threshold. This place and the dark place. Thank you.
These aren't the same tracks that were here before. They're headed into the tree, not out of it. My flashlight burned the dark stuff away. It was covering another page.
The fuse was in place. Saga stepped into the witch's hut. Inside, a bright light. There were objects that stood out to Saga, as if the light had manifested them.
The witch's hut. Okay. I trust the pages to lead me to the overlap.
Anderson, thought I saw something in the woods. Probably just a deer, but I'm gonna check it out.
Okay. I found another page. Following up on a lead. Keep checking in.
Roger.
This is the witch's hut.
Thank you.
page described the hut being lit and mentioned a fuse. Fuse box is missing a fuse. I need to find one to turn on the lights.
The fuse was in place. She found it among the junk in the forest. Saga stepped inside the witch's hut. Something rushed through her. A presence. Familiar. She couldn't quite place it. Something long forgotten. She tried to hold on to it, but it was already gone. Inside, a bright light. Saga felt safe, like nothing could hurt her here. There were objects that stood out to Saga, as if the light had manifested them, pulled them from the darkness. A shift in reality, heavy with hidden meanings. A coffee thermos. A shoebox. A mop and a bucket, a poster on the wall, and in the cabinet, another manuscript page.
This fuse is busted. This one looks good. People should really stop littering, though. Another page. Making progress.
The image of the witch in the sign. Saga addressed the witch. The smudged line on the heart. The second part recited from memory. I brought you the heart, witch. Show me the terror. Saga pushed the heart through the hole in the sign. Witch's ladle. towering over Saga, watching her and the witch. The image of the witch in the sign, Nightingale's heart, a cold, dead lump in her hand. Her definition of sanity had changed since she arrived in this town, but she trusted the pages, was forced to. Saga addressed the witch. She squinted to read the first part of the ritual words, the smudged line on the heart. The second part recited from memory, the words she had read on the page. I brought you the heart, witch. Show me the terror. Saga pushed the heart through the hole in the sign. This was the key. The tree was the threshold.